Hello, my beloved shisha lovers. As I've told you in my vlog, there's going to be an interview with one of the developers of the electronics HTM devices, Artyom, and also there will be excursion through his like the place where he worked in Prague, one of the best shisha places, honestly. So you can see it, and afterwards I'll tell you my personal opinion about this electronic HTM. Let's go.
Now I show you our restaurant. This is door. Let's go with me. It's our bar. Here we have alcohol. We have best coffee in Prague. Here we have shisha zone. This is our black tobacco, this is our light tobacco, mouse sticks, this is our cube for electronic shishas, and here we have classic shisha, our nebula pipes. And here we make calls. We make a lot of shishas, and we need very, very big.
Hello.
Hello. Here is our second room. And let's go downstairs. Downstairs we have a second bar with alcohol, and we have two tables. Here we have downstairs room. In the Saturday and Friday we have karaoke and DJ set here. And now we will smoke electronic shisha and talk more about our restaurant. My name is Artyom Sashnin. I work in restaurant loft number 8. We founder of electronic hookah. We make the best shisha in Czech Republic, and we understand what people need about smoking shisha. I go to the industry to 2016, and I smoke only nahla, I smoke sherbetli, and something like this. But for time I taste another tobacco, like dark side, like sarma, and must have maybe, and I mix it. It was interesting for me to do unusual mix, and this is my way. In the Czech Republic a lot of people smoke light and medium tobacco. The most popular in Czech Republic it's maybe dark side or Czech brand Smoke Island, Chilma. It's like tobacco of Virginia list. But our guests, a lot of our guests from Czech Republic smoke really strong shisha. We teach their smoke satyr, smoke sarma, and it's our guests, and they smoke good shisha now. But in another restaurant in Prague, a lot of people smoke very light shisha without nicotine. We have a lot of young people in our restaurant, and It's between 20 years and 30 years. In Czech Republic, the most popular flavors it's something classic like berries, tropical mix, citrus, and something like this. But for a long time, we working for change mind of people, and we make flavor like bacon, desserts, herbal taste, and something like this. No, in Czech Republic we haven't. If you want to smoke one shisha for 10 people, it's okay. Yes, I know that in Russia people can smoke one shisha for 3 people. Yeah, yes, and but here it's shisha not so popular, and maybe for 10 people only one person will be smoke, and we cannot control this. In our restaurant we have a lot of Russian speaking people, and they give one shisha for one person. If you check people, it's another experience. They can give one shisha for 10 people, but they will be drink beer, they will be eat, and something like this. If it's Russian guests or Ukrainian, Kazakhstan, it will be 1 hour, 1 hour and a half for smoking shisha. And if it's people from Czech Republic, it's between 1 hour and a half and 2 hours. Our features, it's talking with guests. Our guests, it's not our client, it's our friends. We talking with our guests, we joking. And our feature that we smoke electronic shisha. It's innovation for hookah culture, and this is the biggest feature in our restaurant. In our restaurant we have our own shisha. It's Nebula pipes. It's our developing. We have own balls, heat management system, and we have a lot of brands of tobacco. Like Satir, like Sarma, like Dark Side, Tangiers, Sherbetli, Daily Hookah, Blackburn, Overdose. We have really a lot of tobacco. Our restaurant, it's about good smoking. In Czech Republic, we haven't a lot of place where you can smoke really good shisha, where you can smoke really hard, strong shisha, and here we teach people smoke shisha. The most important thing in our electronic shisha, it's clean smoking. It's smoking without coals, and in electronic shisha we haven't gas from charcoals. We have cleaner smoking than smoking with charcoals, and taste is really better. Taste and nicotine, it's very important in shisha. For Russian people, that nicotine it's bigger than classic. Okay. Our electronic shisha, it's very easy. I can show you. Here we have classic tobacco, classic ball, and here we have the most important thing, it's our head, electronic head. Here we have electronic spirals, they warming up tobacco, and here you can control temperature. Minimum it will be 120 and maximum it will be 160. This is temperature in your bowl. and this temperature you can control. This is time of the smoking. We developed this model of electronic shisha for 3 years, and it's our last model. We won't smoke without coals, and we do it. Now we do it, and now we're smoking only electronic shisha in our restaurant. Now we have only one model of electronic shisha, it's this. For all, we have two models. First model was on funnel bowl, and this model in upgrade form. Yeah, we have three differences. It's standard, premium, and exclusive. Standards is soft shisha from like tobacco, like Alfacher, like Sherbetli, Daily Hookah, something like this. Premium, it's mix, strong, dark, and light tobacco. And exclusive, it's only strong tobacco. Yeah, we don't have mixes in the glass because it's unuseful for shisha. We do it a few years ago, but now it's not important. Now I tell you about my three favorite mix. Firstly, it's a mix of beer and brownie cake. Beer from Deus tobacco and brownie from Blackburn. Firstly, you can taste chocolate beer, for the end, you taste something like dessert, something like grilled. My second mix, it will be milk and mint by Sarma, and strawberry by Sarma, wild strawberry. It's a very easy mix, but it's so tasty. You feel milk, mint, and strawberry. And my third mix, maybe it will be bacon, cherry, and peach. Firstly, you can taste fruits, cherry, peach, but for the end you taste something like grilled, something like smoked fruits.
So that's it. That was the small interview and the small opinion on the HTM, and he told us a little bit more about the European culture of smoking shisha. So let me say my personal opinion. I smoked electronic HTM like twice. It was first time on the exhibition in Ostrava, as you remember from the vlog. The link will be somewhere here. And the second time with Artem in his shisha place, in his lounge. Honestly, it's pretty interesting experience. I would not say that I would change my whole smoking habit to electronic device, to electronic HTM, but I think it's the future. If they would develop this machine, that it could give some more heat, because if you're speaking about a product like Satir, Element, or maybe some kind of Trofimovs, when you want some more heat, then it could be really interesting. However, nowadays it could work really well with the products which doesn't have a lot of nicotine. It gives you a really great aromatic experience. So it's really clear aroma. It's like in vape, but it has the base. That's the most important thing, in my opinion, the difference between vaping and smoking shishas. That in vaping, you don't see the base, you just like the clear taste. And here it's a clear taste, clear aromatic taste with aroma. However, there are also minuses. For me, the main minus that, let's say, it gives much more nicotine. And also I was feeling a little bit the ha. So that's really kind of minus for me because I was smoking not really strong shisha. It was like medium. It was like kind of must have. It's a tier or something. So it should not be so strong. But on the electronic HTM, it smokes much, much more stronger. Howard Tom told me the main difference is because the charcoals are hiding the strength, the nicotine. And if you're speaking about the electronic HTM, it gives you the full amount of nicotine. So it could be much harder for even like experienced people to smoke on electronic HTM because there will be much more feeling of the nicotine. There will be same amount of nicotine, but the feeling of it would be much, much stronger. About the aromatic thing, yeah, I liked that it was like a clear taste, but I would say that it also shows if the taste is kind of, you know, like pretty not natural. I assume that this thing will work great with the products which have a kind of natural taste, but if it's kind of even a little bit chemical, like must have some flavors of berries, you can like really feel it. It will feel like soap. It will feel like some kind of perfume or et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So it wouldn't feel good. That's also kind of plus and minus because it reviews all the main aromatic minuses of the product. However, if you're speaking about the Satir, it smoked really good on the electronic HTM, Hookamonk, or they probably will give it another name because they're currently not working with this guy. And they're developing it by themselves. So it has its own pluses and minuses. I think the future of the hookah industry is in electronic HTM because it's really helped to give an easier entrance for a lot of people. And in the lounges, it will be, I think, much more interesting and easier. However, it should be developed. It need to make it still a great way. So I think in 5 to 7 years, the electronic devices would be in the most of the lounges, the electronic HTM. In most of the lounges, because they have like clear pluses, also they have some minuses, but I think most of them would be developed in the next few years. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Click the bell button not to miss new videos. Click the like button so I can see that you are interested in my videos. And write in the comments what you want to know more about the shisha culture, and maybe more about some other products. It was your beloved shisha blogger, Hookah. Have a nice day and bye.